There are lots of paints, glitter or otherwise, available for us to create with, and I'm always interested in trying new or new to me ones, and in today's video, that's what I'm going to do with Folk Art Dragonfly Glaze. Technically, it's not a paint, as the word glaze in the name highlights, but I've used it in a paint-like fashion, and I'm really thrilled with the results. I have 5 color shift options, and in this video, I'll show you some creative ways to have fun with them. Best of all, along with the sparkle and glimmer, we've got them on introductory sale, discounted by 20%. Links to the products can be found in the expanded description below. Dragonfly glaze is multi-surface and it dries to a clear finish, leaving the color-shifting mica what you see. And while Plaid devised this stuff to use as a top coat over other colors, and primarily in home decor, that's not how I'm going to work with it today. Instead, I'm going to treat it pretty much like any other paint, albeit one that dries clear, and I'm going to layer it on tags and pages. I'm going to actually mix it with oxide sprays, which is not my normal for dip and dab, but I'm going to show you that that actually works too, and then I'm going to pull out a gel press plate. One of the things that really sets Dragonfly Glaze apart and distinguishes it is the way that you see the color and that mica. And it really all depends on the angle that the light is striking the surface. The color that you put it on might change, and I'm going to show you swatches in a second, might change it up a little bit, but you're not going to see changes on these swatches. It's when you start to mix it or apply it over other colors that you might see some difference. And then, of course, it's the angle of the light. And where that's really visible is if you're working on something curved. And again, that really works in the home decor field, but that doesn't matter to me. I really like this stuff, and I felt like it was worth bringing it in because it's so interesting. So here are the samples, and what I did was here are the swatches, rather than just put them on a white tag, because as you can see by the white on the bottom, and I'm going to hold this up, because it dries clear, it's better on a dark or at least a colored surface. So I have, this is just a number 12 watercolor tag, and for all of them, I layered black, smooth and sturdy, craft, and wet cement, and then applied the color with a brayer. So you can see that this one, which is blue, green, gold, because of the way the light is striking it, we're seeing that is mostly gold. Here is green, gold, red, and this one obviously very different. Now on the white, let's see if I can get that to reflect. It looks a little bit pink, but really where you see it is on these other colors. And again, it's all a factor of what angle the light strikes it at. So here is gold, red, and violet. Different than what I showed you just a second ago, because this one is a little bit more intense. And again, a very light version on the white. This is red, violet, blue. And this one looks violet, and again, what we're seeing here, less so down here, but if I bend this, see how the color changes when the light strikes it? This one looks more blue-violet than this up here, which I see is reading a little bit more red. And then the last color I've got is violet blue green. Again, depending on how the light strikes it is going to affect what you see. And this one actually looks pretty white at the bottom, but if you look at it here at the top, let's see if I can get that the light to reflect. While it looks white too, this one looks completely different when you start putting it over colors. And that's the thing you have to keep in mind. Don't be disappointed if you don't get exactly what you expect, and that's part of the fun that works with this, because it's kind of like Forrest Gump's box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get, and it really is a factor of that light, the curve, and what you put it on. So I'm going to try something really basic. I'm going to work, I've got 3 colors of Fresco Finish paint. I have Peacoat, Sugar Plum, and Cerulean, and I need to grab the bottle of, what did I say I was going to use here? Red, Violet, Blue. So I need to find that one. Red, Violet, Blue. There we go. So the color names are all on the front here. They have this really cool holographic label, which I will say can make them a little bit difficult to read. So you might want to label these in a way that's easier for you to read. So I'm going to give all of these a little bit of a shake. Now the recommendation is that you shake these, but honestly the paint is so thick I haven't found that the color settles, or the mica settles, but I'm going to go ahead and give it a little bit of a shake. So I'm going to bring this in. I've got my small brayer and I've got 3 number 5 tags in the black, craft, and wet cement. I'm going to put a little bit of each of these colors out. Theoretically, I'm going to put a little bit out. Sometimes it ends up being more than that, but we'll see how that works. And I'm going to apply it the same way that you've probably seen me do in the past, on a tag. I'm just going to brayer some on and see what happens. Now, in terms of the dragonfly glaze, I can layer this on pretty much like I can with the other colors, in any order that I want. But one of the things that can be interesting is if you put some on, put some color around it, and then you start to really build up layers. So as is my norm, I'm going to go ahead and start with the lighter colors, and I have way too much paint here because that is my gift, to use too much paint. So let's bring out one each of the other colors, and I'll work on 6 tags rather than 3. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and brayer some of this on each of the tags, and way too much color, even for this. All right, so let's someplace here. I've got this big tag here. I'm just going to brayer this off on this big tag. I'm going to ignore this. We'll clean this up after. I'm going to come in and grab the cerulean, and I'm going to put a little bit of color on each of these tags. When I do this, it is my tendency to work north and south and east and west. I don't work on the diagonal, and that was something I learned from Leandra at Paper Artsy. That was her suggestion, and I found that I much prefer the results when I do that. All right, so let's brayer this off, and let's grab, you know what, let's come in with some of the Dragonfly Glaze and brayer that on now, and it's going to be very subtle until I hold it up so that you can see it. Whoops, that was not what I meant to do, but that's all right. So let's go ahead and get this on, and I'm going to put some more of this out because it's good stuff and I want to use a lot. I mean, art makes me happy. Creating makes me happy. Creating with something that's glittery or glimmery makes me even happier. I'm easy to please. If it shines or it shimmers, I'm pretty much enamored with it. All right, so let's put just a little bit more on here because if we're going to use it, we might as well have it work. All right, so now I'm going to come into the pea coat and start to brayer some of that on. Now, I'm going to see less of that on the black than I will on these others, but that's okay because everything is different, and if it were all samey-samey, life would be boring. Now, I've probably used enough of the Dragonfly Glaze that I don't necessarily have to put any more on, so, and of course, this hasn't dried yet, but you can see where it's wet. It's less easy to see the shimmer. But let's come back with some of this, and that's okay that it muddies up a bit. I'm not really worried about that. Let's add a little bit more here, and muddy is not the word I should have used. It really just blended a little bit. So it's pretty easy to get this color on, and let me grab these. So I was playing around with these before, and I actually used 2 colors, and don't ask me which 2 because I don't remember. But you can see that it shines gold here, and then, whoops, if I hold this up this way, there it is. Here's the other color down here, and I don't remember which one it was. Let's see, there we go. See, that's better. We can really see it. It has to dry. That carrier, the liquid that it's in, has to become transparent for it to be easily visible. So because I've got a fair amount of this left here, I'm going to roll it out on these and just go for the gusto. Let's let the Dragonfly Glaze do its thing and shine and look marvelous here. All right, so I'm going to put these to one side, get them out of the way. Now something interesting, I've got this paint left. Something interesting that you can do is rather than let it go to waste, I can kind of pick it up, and even though it's partly dry, I can scrub it on this tag. And it just creates an entirely different background kind of look. You know, I mean, why waste it? It's sitting there. All right, that's enough. So let's go ahead and just put some water down, and I'll clean this up. And now next thing I'm going to do is dip and dab, because as much as you wouldn't expect that to be a great technique to do with paint, and I don't ordinarily do this, I thought, oh, what the heck, let's give it a try. It worked really well. There goes the heat tool falling off of the table. All right, so let me show you the samples that I created, and then I will show you how I created them. So these are the 3 samples. Now, admittedly, the light green color doesn't show up super well, but when I hold this up and let it catch the light, maybe it'll be easier to see on the black. Let it catch the light, you can see that I've got the sparkle, And I've got the pattern, because this went on fairly thick. You can see the pattern that it kind of went on in. So this one is more all over sparkle, which I think is really, really pretty. It can be sometimes defying to try to get, there we go, try to get this in the light so that you can really see it. So colors, I have three colors of oxide sprays. I have Picked Raspberry, Tumble Glass, and Dusty Concord. And then what color was I going to use? I don't think I had chosen a color. So let's go ahead. What is this? This is blue, green, gold. Well, I've got pink in here, so let's see if we can grab, what's this? This is gold, red, and violet. All right, well, close enough. So we'll go ahead and give these a shake. Actually, I take that back. I'm going to use this one, which is violet, blue, green, because that's kind of closer to the three colors I'm working with here. So normal dip and dab, other than the fact that I'm going to add paint. That means I'm going to put the colors out kind of in a pattern. Not that the pattern matters. And now I'm going to dribble some of the paint in there, and then I'm going to put a little bit of water in. There we go. You can tell I like this color. Now, ordinarily, I would not monkey around with this, but I'm going to just kind of spread it out a little bit. All right. Wipe my fingers. And I'm going to put some water in here. Now, obviously, where the paint is the heaviest is where it's going to glob on the most. But that's okay, because it creates really fun, interesting backgrounds. So I've got watercolor tags. Again, I'm back with the... Let's move these out of the way. Back with the Craft Black and Wet Cement. And I'm going to start dipping and dabbing. Oh, okay. So again, you really can't see the mica in there because it's not dry. But I think these are going to be great. So I'm going to stop once I get this first layer on all of them. And I'm going to dry them because I need to do that in order to be able to get that next coat on. And I am deliberately getting into the dragonfly glaze. That's my whole point here. I want that on here. Okay, so I've got these three done. Let me take these to the side for 1 second, dry them off, and then I'll come back and I'll put another layer on. Before I dip and dab the second layer, because the first one is dry, you will be able to see the dragonfly glaze now, and you can see the reflection on here, and then as I start to bend this, you can see it even more. But it's beautifully sparkly, and it's just really so much fun to work with. And here is the Craft, and I have discovered, since we brought in the Craft and the wet cement, that I really love working with these. I mean, the black is great too, don't mistake that. The black is just an awesome surface to work on, but this gives me an entirely different look. And again, when you have this much glittery stuff, it's hard to go wrong. I put a little bit more of the Dusty Concord and the Tumble Glass down because things had kind of gotten pink, and I felt like I wanted to bring in some of those other colors too. All right, that looks pretty good. I'm going to hit where I know the dragonfly glaze is, and then I'm going to come back and pick up some of these other colors again. Now, I could do more layers. I've got enough stuff out here that I could do more layers, but I don't want this to all kind of run together and become a solid layer. I like all that patterning. So once I'm done here and shut the video off or stop the camera from running, I will come back and do some other stuff. So this is, again, it's gotten to be a little bit samey-samey, so what I think I'm going to do is go ahead and spatter some of the Dusty Concord on there. Well, and that's my problem. That's too close. I need a darker purple. All right, so here's Wilted Violet. And I think this is going to be darker, so it's, yeah. See, that's a little bit different green, a different purple. So that's going to kind of give it a better look. So again, you're not going to be able to see the dragonfly glaze now because these are wet, but I'll take photos of all of this stuff that we've done, and we'll post them on social media, and they'll be in the newsletter at some point, so you'll be able to see kind of the effect, and this stuff is just too good to miss. So up next, I'm going to clean this up, and I'm going to bring out a gel plate, and I'm going to show you how you can use dragonfly glaze to make interesting layers, and you can even pull a pickup print with it. You really can't beat Dragonfly Glaze on black for high contrast drama, so that's the first print I'll make. I'm going to add a layer of green, gold, red to the plate. I'm going to use our Bubble Blast stencil, and then I'm going to use black smooth and sturdy tags and index cards, and I'm going to pick up the paint and make prints, and but that'll make sense as I do it. So here are some examples of Dragonfly Glaze on black. Now again, it's really hard because you got to get the light to reflect just right. Here I was playing with Bubble Blast. In some cases the colors are, well, that one doesn't show very well, does it? Neither does this one. But in some cases, obviously the colors are going to change. See how I've got this bluish color over here and up here based on the light? It's kind of that pinky purple color. So that's the magic of this stuff. That's going to affect what you see. Again, it's all about the way the light strikes the surface. So let's go ahead and do this. Put those up there. Let me grab some black tags. I've got little tags. I don't think I've got any big tags around, but I've got some index cards. So I've got Bubble Blast, I've got my plate, and I've got, what did I say this was? Green, gold, red. So I'm going to layer out a reasonably, oh, you know what? I need roll-off sheets. Hold on. Let me put them where I can get to them. All right. Let me just throw these up here and out of the way. So I'm going to put a fair amount of this on. Because I'm working with only this, I want to be able to see it. That should be enough. So I'm going to brayer out a layer of this, and again, it's very unexciting when you look at it this way. I'm going to leave what's on the brayer because there's a fair amount, and we'll just see how that goes in a second. So here comes Bubble Blast. Now what I'm going to do is bring in some index cards, and I'm going to put these face down on here so that I can pick up the color that's in the openings of the stencil. And then I will print what's left. All right. I don't have a number 8 tag, which is kind of a bummer because I have space here for one, but oh well. So now I need to grab a sheet of something else to use. Here's what I was looking for. All right. So I'm just going to go ahead. This is the Yasumoto. Am I pronouncing that correctly? Now I'm having a moment. Anyway, this is that paper, and I'm just using it to keep my hands reasonably clean. So obviously, because this paper is thick, I have to press, not this paper, the paper that is the index tags and the cards is thick. I want to press really well to make certain that I pick up that color through the openings in the Bubble Blast stencil. I can do that with the heel of my hand, I can do it with my fingertips. I mean, it's not like you have to bend anything to get that done, but you do need to do that. So there shouldn't be much of anything on here, and in fact there's not, because most of my surface is covered. So you can see that I've got color and shimmer going on there. So let's put those up there. And they need to dry, but again, once this is dry, it'll be easier to see, although you can certainly see kind of that red color in there. So now I'm going to take Bubble Blast off and put it to one side, and then I'm going to take more of the index cards and the tags, whoops, and I'm going to lay them out here. So I'm going to get both the positive and the negative of Bubble Blast when I print like this. Put that there, grab a tag here, and let's grab this again. And just go ahead and print what's left. So this is a way that I can get color and pattern and shimmer and glimmer on pages, tags, whatever they are, index cards, really easily, and I get a lot done for that one application of paint. So here you can see, well, let's hold this up so you can see it. You can see there's the Bubble Blast design, so there's one version of it, and here is the positive version. So this is the positive version because I have the color in printed from the openings of the stencil, and this is the negative, oh look at how that color shifts, this is the negative version because it's technically the background. Now I have enough color left, let's pick these up, I have enough color left on my plate, or excuse me, on my brayer, that rather than waste it, I'm going to go ahead and brayer it on here, because this stuff is too good to waste, and then I'm just going to use this roll-off sheet and I'm going to pick it all up, just because I don't want to waste it. The second print I'm going to create is going to start with an ombre that I print, so you're not going to really see anything on here, it's just shimmer. The second print I'm going to create is an ombre. Let's get rid of the little holes from the tags as a background. So I've got, this is Amsterdam acrylic. This is permanent red violet, and this is permanent blue violet. I have a whole pad. This is the, again, the Yasutomo. I did pronounce it incorrectly before. The Yasutomo. This is the 9x12 rice paper that Elizabeth uses. It's smooth on one side, and you can feel it's a little rougher on the other, and typically you would print on this smooth side, so that's what I'm going to do. So let's go ahead and get an ombre going on here. And I deliberately chose dark colors because I want the dragonfly glaze to react with it. I've got my roll-off sheets. What am I doing here? Let's make sure I have the right color. This is, here we go. So I'm going to use gold, red, violet for this. But first I need to create the ombre. So I'm going to do that by brayering this color out on one half of the plate, rolling it off, and then I'm going to grab the other color and start moving it across the plate too. And then I'll let them kind of blend in the center. Now I might be able to get two prints out of this. We'll have to see. So here is my paper. I'm just going to lay that down. Go ahead and pull the print. And there is enough, again, just a pretty ombre. There is enough on here to grab a ghost print, so I'm going to do that. This time, rather than use Bubble Blast, okay, boy, do I like ghost prints. I think that they're so interesting. So this time I'm going to use the design, and if you could see my workbench, you'd know why I can't find anything. This is from Elizabeth's, I believe this is from her original Klimt collection, and it's named Mirror Mirror. So what I'm going to do is take gold, red, violet, and I'm going to apply it to the plate like you saw me do a moment ago. And I'm going to be pretty liberal with it. And I'm going to leave what's on the brayer on the brayer rather than roll it off in case I decide I need it. So here comes Mirror Mirror. Now for this one, what I'm going to do is I've got some tags that I made previously that have fairly dark backgrounds. I'm going to arrange these on here in a way that I'm going to press them and pick up what is in the openings of the mask. Some of these are probably going to work better than others. We'll see how it goes. That looks pretty good. Let's put that one there. I don't know that I can get another one here, but let's try. Oh, I can. All right, so now I'm going to grab, again, this is just, well, this is a roll-off sheet. I don't know how that's going to work, but we'll see. So now I want to come through and I want to do the same thing. I want to press pretty hard so that I pick up the color through the openings of that mask and print it onto those index cards and tags. And then I'm going to come back and print on my ombre. So let's see what we've got. Yeah, not super visible there. You can see a little bit of it. I think it's probably going to be more so. Well, again, you can see kind of it on, oh, there we go. You can see it on there. So let's toss those over there and get them out of the way. Now what I'm going to do, because there's still, again, there we go. I like this design. Because there's still a fair amount of dragonfly glaze on the plate, ooh, that one's kind of fun. I'm going to grab, what do we got here? I have another roll-off sheet rolling around here. I'm just going to pick up the rest of the color so that I get the effect that I want, which is to save the paint that's under the mask, and that's going to be what prints on my ombre background. All right. Again, you're not going to really see this, so I'm not even going to bother to show it to you. Now I'm going to take the mask, and I'm going to pick it up and toss it over there. And here comes, this is not completely dry, but close enough. So now I'm going to print, and I don't know that I'm going to get a ghost print out of this, but we'll figure something out. So if I print this, it will, oh, how pretty is that? Look at that pink color on there. It looks pink on the pink, and it looks pink on the purple. Let's see if I can get this to change at all if it bends. Oh, see how over here in that light it starts to look a little bit silver, which is not one of the names of the color, or one of the names of the color in the name, but nevertheless, that's really pretty. All right, let's see what happens if there's anything on here. I don't really think that there is. And if there is, I think it's going to be so light that you're really not going to see it. Let's see. Yeah, you can't really see it on there. So what I can do instead is just brayer this out, and that's still got some of the other paint on it, and just go ahead and print it on here. I mean, I've got all that dragonfly glaze. I don't want to waste it. And again, you're probably not going to see anything other than a layer of shimmer because there's no pattern in this one. All right, so something else that you can actually do, let's get rid of this, is create a pickup print. This is something I was messing around with earlier, and this is, let me think about this. This is from Elizabeth's new O'Keeffe collection, and it's named Kana. And I want to get this laid on there. The plate has a tendency to stretch. So this is completely dry. It's been sitting here for a while now. Let's get, well, I need to brayer this off. So what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to come back with this same, I want something that's going to provide a really nice look. This is gold, red, violet shift. All right, let's use this and see how this looks. I'm just going to pick this up and I'm going to pick it up on the white paper. I have no idea if this is going to work really well, but I have someplace here, I have a print that I did, that a pickup print that I did that I can show you if we need to. The thing with a pickup print is you need to have a really thin layer on here, and typically I would tell you, you need to be able to see through the paint to whatever it is you're trying to pick up. But obviously it's a little bit different because this is completely transparent. So let's go ahead and throw stuff all over the place and go ahead and put this on here. So with a pickup print, where I started to go with that is you need a really thin layer of whatever it is that you're using to pick up, because you need it to actually dry and grab the plate, the paint that has been sitting on the plate. So sometimes it can take a moment or two or five. Let's see. All right, that's pretty close. We're almost there. I was actually better. I'm not really good at light layers, so sometimes it takes a little longer. Okay, here we go. Now, whether or not you're going to see a super amount of shimmer on here remains to be seen. But yeah, because this is on white, if I'd had something that already had a dark background printed, you can just catch glimmers of it here and there. But the larger point is, if you use a proper color background, you can do a pickup print with this. So these are the Plaid Folk Art Dragonfly Glazes. Five marvelous groups, or five marvelous combinations of mica that color shifts. And we've got them here in stock at the warehouse, and you'll save 20% on them all.